In this video, we will use a skin wrap modifier combined with the power and features of Facial Studio to use custom head geometry. Our custom 3D head model here is just an editable mesh at the moment. If it were an editable poly, the exact same technique would apply. And we also have this Facial Studio head in the scene with an FFD box applied on top. The reason we have an FFD box applied on the Facial Studio head is to have it match the other head as much as possible, as you can see here after we've aligned the two. I can make a quick adjustment to the ear's rotation in order to make it fit even better, like this. Okay, so we have this 3D head, created with Facial Studio, with an FFD modifier on top. Let's go to the object properties, and in the display properties, check display as box. So we have our custom head object here, and here, we have the Facial Studio primitive. But as you can see, it is displayed as a box. So what I'll do now is select the head, and apply skin wrap modifier. Once the skin wrap modifier is applied, inside of the skin wrap, we will just click Add and select the Facial Studio head, which is displayed as a box. So this means that we have applied the Facial Studio head as a deformation on the face. Still in the skin wrap modifier, let's check Weigh All Points. And if we now move the timeline, thanks to an animation I had previously created, we can see that some problematic areas are easily identified. Simply adjusting some of the spinners can solve these problems and make the deformation smoother. Once all of this is done, the head model can be animated using the Facial Studio head as a deformation. To do that, I simply need to select the Facial Studio head. And then in the animation sub-object, I could, for instance, choose to trigger the smile, the asymmetrical smile or the symmetrical smile, or I could simply trigger the mouth opening. Tweaking all of these different shapes allows us to create new morph targets really rapidly for our custom geometry. If we want, we can go back to the skin wrap and really tweak the settings to get the best results. Once these settings are tweaked and optimized, we can go back to the Facial Studio parameters and then create different poses and animate the 3D head we've just created using the Facial Studio engine. So Facial Studio combined with the skin wrap modifier allows us to create facial animations using the Facial Studio engine, but with your own head geometry. Thank you for watching this brief overview on how to combine Facial Studio with 3ds Max's skin wrap modifier. For more information and to download trials of Facial Studio and other Di-O-Matic products, please visit our website at www.diomatic.com.